कल्पना आचार्य, एडिटर ऑफ हेल्थ टीवी नेपाल, एंड शी इज ऑल्सो फाउंडिंग मेंबर ऑफ द एशिया पैसिफिक मीडिया नेटवर्क फॉर हेल्थ एंड डेवलपमेंट. कल्पना विल स्पीक ऑन द रोल ऑफ मीडिया एज वन ऑफ द की कॉग्स इन द व्हील्स फॉर डेवलपमेंट, जस्टिस एंड डेमोक्रेसी. ओवर टू यू कल्पना.
Thank you, Sabha ji. Thank you so much for giving me this wonderful opportunity to share my ideas here in important session. Hi, everyone. Namaste and greetings from Nepal. I am Kalpana, especially health journalist. I'm doing health journalism since 15 years. I am the past president of Health Journalist Forum Nepal. This is the national network of health journalists here in Nepal. And I also teach mass communication and journalism subject in bachelor's level here in Nepal. Through this session, I just want to share my ideas, what is the role of media for the development of democracy and gender equality. Okay, can you share, can you see my slide?
Yes, we can, yes.
Okay. Through this session, briefly, we suppose that media is the mirror of the society and media can play a great role to change the society in various ways. That's why a media plays a very significant role in keeping everyone updated about the various events around the world. Today, we can check out the latest news and current affairs with just a few clicks of mouse. We simply say that a vast majority of people, even now also all across the world, depend on various sources of media for keeping themselves updated and various ongoing issues around the world. Media plays an important role for the whole society. We know that media also play a very important role in the building of a society and development, justice and democracy, which I want to discuss today. In today's world, media has become almost as necessary as food. So it is mirror of the society and plays an outstanding role in the strengthening it. When we talk about the how media can play for the development, justice and gender equality, it gives us immense knowledge and transmit information. This is the role of media. Media keeps us informed about various happening around the world. It lets us know what is happening around us and all over the world with the help of media. We get immense knowledge on various subjects. It updates information from time to time so that the general public stay aware of what is going on in the country and the entire world. This is the information role of mass media. This is very strongest role of mass media, we say. And number two is raises our consciousness. Media raises awareness by providing information and knowledge. In media, not only give the information, important information, it advocates the issues. It does not impose its own opinion on us, but provides facts, figures, and news to us so that we can analyze the information and can understand what is wrong and what is right. It gives the shape of opinion to the audiences. Number third is, media raises voice against issues in societies. We know that media also plays a constructive role for the society by raising the awareness of issues. There are many examples of social issues like gender equality, gender rights, SRHR, sexual and reproductive health rights, human rights, etc. We say that have been raised by media. When media presents and unveils such issues, the public becomes aware and the necessary steps are taken for resolving these types of issues and problems. So media have many roles. We can discuss on that. Next, please. Number four is, we simply say provide, media provides true pictures and live telecast. Any live event happening right now can be watched everywhere. This is the information is today. For example, conferences, we are doing this session. This is also live. A political address by a PM or leaders, live coverage of areas affected by flooding, or just any other incident. Media helps us see the exact picture by providing the live recorded telecast through the pictures, through the photos, illustrations for almost all important events. Number five is educates the society. When we talk about the role of the media, it not only inform and give the awareness, it also educates the society directly and indirectly. One of the most important role of the media is to educate the society. We can explore and analyze various products, reviews, do price comparison for various items, read news about politics, fashion, war, weather, health, and much more, right, with the help of media. So media exposes issues like poverty, illiteracy, social backwardness, and lots of issues through media can educate the society. It also educates people about their rights and duties and helps enforce law as well. When we talk about the role of education, we simply say, talking about the Nepal's situation, we have a geographically a very difficult country. That's why through the distance education, through the tele communication, they can get and informal education, distance education through the television, radio. So media not only informs the public, not only aware the public, not only the advocacy role, media directly and indirectly educates the society too. Next, please. When we talk about the functions of media, roles of media, we should be responsible. We media persons should be responsible. Media, not only the free, we suppose free media, but media, not only the free, there should be journalists should be responsible and accountable, whatever they do. A free media functions as a watchdog that can investigate and report on government wrongdoings. Yes, that's why this is called watchdog of the society and watchdog of the nation. A free and objective media is an essential component of any democratic society. We believe in that. That's why media are the pillars of the democratic society. For that, we should have three major areas are here. I want to highlight state obligations toward the free and independent media, number one. Number two, enabling environment for journalists to advocate development and justice. And number third is adherence to media ethics, responsibility, and accountability in doing justice to our roles. So media must have the responsible role too. We have lots of medias like social medias and other kinds of media tools to communicate, but we should differentiate between social media and the mainstreaming media. We have to differentiate it. If we differentiate these two types of media, then we can choose which one is right and which one is wrong. Next, please. Talking about the responsible and free media, states and governments have responsibility to protect free media. Democratic states do that even by encouraging media to criticize their works, so to have balance of power among executive, legislative, and judiciary. Media is known as the fourth state. It is supposed only, it is not by the law, media is only at the first stage because of its role only to watch upon organs of democratic state. It is high time that media checks and balance power, watches on wrongdoings of the power centers. And at the top that, states should encourage media to show them right way towards fulfilling obligation-laden citizens. So governments also have some responsibility to strengthen the media. Number two is mass media is considered as the voice of voiceless people. If there is some problems of voiceless people, media may be the voice of that kind of people. This tunes well in advocating and protecting rights of individuals without fear and favor. Hence, journalists need to know about the country's obligations towards citizens' rights, also to check whether governments abide by their commitment to protecting human rights, mainstreaming deprived people to the process development. So mass media should know the country's rules and regulations and treaties and what type of sign a government done and did earlier. Next, please. And the third is Article 19 of the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights states the right to freedom of speech, that everyone shall have the right to hold opinions without interference and freedom to seek, receive and impart information and ideas, all kinds, regardless of frontiers, either orally, in writing or in a print, in the form of art or through any other media of his or her dear choice. So media should watch on governments whether they have ratified this and similar treaties, introduce law according to international commitment. What is your country's treaties and what they signed? Media should watch and ratify that type of treaties and laws. Next, please. And we know that journalism is a profession guided by the ethics. There should be ethical journalism for the democracy and strengthen the gender equality and gender justice and other kind of justice. Adherence to media ethics, responsibility and accountability in doing justice to our roles is key to ensuring human rights and inclusive participation. So I think all journalists should go through code of ethics prepared and enforced by professional associations or press councils and or similar organizations. The fundamental and universal principles within any code of ethics call on, we simply say in journalism, ABC, accuracy, balance, and credibility. Do no harm principles, defending freedom of information, comment and criticism, reporting facts without distortion. In some cases, we see distortion some defamations and other kinds of information, misinformation and disinformation. Staying away from plagiarism, defamation and unfounded accusations. And extra attention towards gender identity, gender role, disability, minors, and children. So these are the professional ethics guided by the ethics and code of conduct. All journalists should follow these types of ethics and code of conduct for the ethical and responsible journalism. Next, please. Okay, I want to share this infodemic. Here is not only pandemic, here is also information pandemic problems also occur in all over the world, not in only in Nepal. Information plus pandemic is equal infodemic. It means this type of situation in which a lot of false information is being spread in a way that may be harmful for us. in COVID-19 pandemic, we have faced infodemic problems. We should be careful, especially we journalists, which one is right and which information is wrong. Because if we journalists share through the social site and social media, it may be wrong. That's why we should verify the right sources and right quotes. How much of this information is accurate, we should be assured that before sharing. Because social media's followers and social media users can share the information, but journalists should think about it before the sharing. It reaches to thousands of people. That's why we should be careful and should be responsible for the wrong information and right information. Next, please. Okay, this is my last slide. To promote credible journalism, one must adhere to ethical standards and promote strong norms and professional journalism. If we simply say journalism must follow the basic principles and journalism must follow the laws guided issued by the Press Council and other organizations, improve competence and digital literacy. we should competent in digital, this is the information age, this is the technology age, that's why we should be familiar. This is the basic knowledge and skill. And expose disinformation campaigns. We simply see lots of informations, disinformations and misinformations are occur in this pandemic situation. As I earlier mentioned that infodemic, that's why expose disinformation campaigns. Resist manipulation, we should not manipulate the information, data and other things. That's why we want not only free media, but accountable, credible, and responsible media should be there. Saying this, we all journalists should be responsible. Not only talk about the freedom, we should be accountable, credible, responsible for gender equality, gender justice, development justice, and all. Saying this, I want to stop here. Thank you again to organizers, Babiji, Sobhaji, and all participants. Thank you. If there is any query, I would like to respond. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kalpana. Thank you for just reiterating and reminding us what should be the role of the media. We have a few questions for you, Kalpana. Waki Kothithani from Thailand wants to know that as a senior media editor, did you face any challenge in your journey because of being a woman?
Yes, thank you for the questions. Yes, my earlier friends discussed on that. Being a woman journalist, we have lots of challenges. I started my career 20 years ago as a radio journalist. At that time, this is the government-owned media, radio. This is called Radio Nepal. And we have 24 staffs, journalists in whole newsroom. Only one woman, that is me. That was me, okay? So at that time, women's participations and engagements were very less. That's why we don't have, even now also, some media houses don't have separate toilets, you know? Now, we have to go in same toilet which are used by men. So this is the small challenge we faced when talk about the opportunity, when some opportunities come and then name come to males, male journalist. So she is a woman and she can't do this, and she has family, she has to go home earlier. That's why don't give this responsibility to female journalists. This kind of challenges faced a lot in my career. Even now also we have facing lots of challenges and we are struggling, but I did not give up my passion, and now I'm here.
Okay, thank you. A question from Mendicinemi from PNG, that big media corporations and social media corporations are not letting media follow ethics, as profit takes primacy over ethics. Is it true in Nepal? And Nahid also wants to know that is the media free in Nepal, and how much of interference is there from the government?
Thank you for the questions. Yes, now media is free to communicate, disseminate any kind of information. This is because this is the democratic country. But yes, some obstacles from the power centers and some mafia groups and other groups, pressure groups, we simply say pressure groups, have sometimes there is obstacles. Otherwise, media is free. Another question is social media and mainstream media is definitely there are vast differences between social media and mainstreaming media. Social media, I simply say social media is 2D can. This is in our Nepal, we have large land, which is called Tudikel. This is Tudikel. Whoever can come and they can deliver their speech, they can express their views. But media house and journalists are different. We have some obligations and we have some ethics. We have some code of conducts. We should have followed that code of conduct and ethics to deliver and to disseminate our informations, because we have a responsibility towards the citizens. We have freedom of expression. We have rights, but we have bounded by some code of ethics. That's why social media and social media users and media professionals and journalists are different. They should be more professional and more accountable and more responsible.
Okay. Thank you very much, Kalpana. And as I said, the conversation continues. It yes. does not end here.
Shubha,
sir, thank sorry. You.
Yes, sorry. There is, okay, Bobby. Yes, Bobby's hand is raised. Yes, Bobby.
Yes, sorry. I just wanted to say, because we have Kalpana right now on the stage, so we just wanted to hear from her, because Kalpana Acharya has led from the front in terms of media person in helping ensure that Nepal stands true with its obligation for tobacco control. And there are many instances where she has played important role in ensuring that media holds the government to account, because government has to implement tobacco control, not tobacco industry efforts. So even during COVID, industry tried to do something, and you all mobilized everyone, all the civil society and media came together. And Kalpana, can you share, because that is a very positive example how media organizations are playing a very important role in not only holding government to account, but also saving people's lives because of tobacco, from tobacco hazards. So over to you.
Yes, Babiji, I have a wonderful experience during the COVID-19 pandemic. Yes, Nepal is the first country to implement the 90% pictorial health warning signage. But unfortunately, I think now Nepal is second, third in list because of the government's negligency. In COVID-19 pandemic time, the tobacco industries, which is very biggest industry in Nepal, Shure Tobacco, tried to leaders use in their campaign, and they tried to give, not only tried, they already given. Seven provinces ministers, they gave 5 crores per province for the COVID-19 pandemic patients or whatever management. But in that time, media persons, we journalists united together, and we campaign. This is the against the law. Tobacco industries cannot give and support the government to any kind of activities through the tobacco taxes money. That's why we tried to back that money, and we wrote lots of stories against them. And government also felt that, and governments taken this step backward. So in Nepal's tobacco companies' interference are very high because of the leadership. But media's role is very important to implement the law. Even we are fighting to implement 90% pictorial health warning must be there because this case is on the court. That's why we are not doing anything. Otherwise, we are still fighting, Babiji.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And that was a big victory for at least giving one kick out to the big tobacco industry.
Another is our medical council president tried to receive 5 crore rupees from the tobacco industries, but we convinced him, and we write up lots of articles against him and tobacco industries. That's why he rejected to receive that token of money.
Okay, great. A big clap for the journalist.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And